sign of improvement, Mrs. Ballard has decided to talk to her teachers about what might be at the root of her behaviour.
Can you say at the beginning how it's really...
She did every task.
Yeah.
You know, she's using all the right things that I've asked her to use. She then went away and did the speech.
Even like her punctuation thing is smart, you see.
And then every now and again we see glimpses of it when it's on a topic she likes. But then we say, okay, it takes a lot to get this out of now. Like, all of a sudden, no capital
letters. Much bigger writing.
She's scribbling, she's not taking care of the book. And then even here today, supposed to be doing like showing not tell, so describing what it looks like. Not even a sentence, instead of coming at me like, you can do a sentence.
I think I was probably invisible to the teachers in my school as somebody that actually just wasn't going to do well. So it's very important that actually we look to see what's underneath the behaviour. It is clear to me that although she's a bright girl, that Emily's struggling in class. I think she has low confidence, low self-esteem, and I think that that's really affected her.
This is Barrow. Get to the bottom of Emily's troubles.
She's a mixture, because when you first meet her, I think you definitely think she's really confident, but I think actually when you get to know her and you sit down with her and you have an eye on the cure. Remember on review day, and we talked about confidence, didn't we? And you said, what would affect your confidence?
My anger.
About time when it has affected your confidence.
That time in English when we had to do our thing, our speeches.
Easy in your mind. You are somebody that wants to be the knight in shining armour protecting all the girls, right? So he sort of becomes the arch enemy to you, with you becoming the hero that actually sorts all this stuff out. If you ever go and watch Spanx when they're young, with their big horns, they do this thing called rutting, and it's when they crash into each other with their horns and see who's the strongest man. This tie between the two of you, because actually, we are proud of you for being much more mature and grown up. It hasn't led to a fight, because it's managed to stop. But today, the sort of talk there are your feelings about each other. So do you
feelings?
Enough to have handshake over there.
No.
Stop off.
Thank you.
that you've got to draw the line somewhere. We decided to keep you in the same class together to prioritise and prepare for exams, but also to just stay in year 11, so they've made a promise to make sure that actually they're sticking to that promise. I do hope that they will. Every piece of me in my heart
hopes that they will. I know they will.
It's halfway through term, and year 9 Emily is continuing.